think that's good. No, it's
four eyes.
There we go. Okay. You can also not have it on and just do this.
Sure.
If
I do.
But it keeps my ears warm.
Sorry, what? Yeah, no, yeah, we're good, we're good. You guys are good to go. No, you're good. Alright, so this is, I know we just played Losers Finals, but we're gonna play Losers Semis.
Yeah.
2, 1, go!
This is how it works here in Texas. At CPS,
two for a dollar. Every time you're not sponsored by Arizona Tees.
Yeah,
you can get yourself a band Arizona Tees or two for a dollar.
At CVS Pharmacy, too.
So, like, I'm a huge fan of both. To be completely honest. So, Bay's neutral. With Bay, it's just ridiculous. I'm playing St. Paul. He's a great guy. I've known him for a long time.
Sorbet is also a player who is always on the move, always thinking, he's always there, he's always either in your face or knowing when to retreat and knowing when to cover your landing. That's what Pit's supposed to be, and Sorbet puts it up, cranks it up, cranks up the speed.
Yeah, definitely. He's a very, very nice player. Even players like Wispy have commentated on this hard best move.
Like, just look at, like, everything that's going on here. Like, one of the more unfortunate things about this matchup, though, is that Sorbet could be doing that, putting in a lot of work, but he could die at 60.
And here we go. Just as stated.
My god. Maybe he demonstrated there.
Let's see how much ball angle can get off this. Looks like he missed no punish, though. He's based out accordingly.
He's going for a lot of his smash attacks because he does realize they're multi-hits, but
yeah.
I haven't seen Maniac Chase use focus that much at all, so I feel like he's just trying to catch a tap with it.
You saw there, he's putting all that backwards to see how he would play. Looks like he hopefully might use it to his advantage. The dash back into there, could connect.
Misses the sweet spot there, keeps Sorbet alive.
However, yeah, I was about to say, he is at kill percent, and there it is. Up tilt, Shorty, you can. What do you do? You try game and watch at 60. Like,
game and watch, it's like 40.
Yeah, no, yeah, I die way earlier than you don't worry. You're doing fine.
Second lightest character in the game, right? Gamer.
Third. Kirby and Trigger, though.
No, no, not Kirby. There's someone else between them. Is it Mewtwo?
No, Mewtwo is.
Mewtwo got buffed in the weight, though.
Yeah. Yeah, fatty.
Double fatty. He weighs like 200 some pounds in the Pokedex.
3, 2,
it's all in there.
1,
he should be a second charge. Hey, not according to Smash. Oh, my. I like the Sage, just for Sorbet's sake,
yeah.
Because until my either save him or let him die at the exact same percent, so it's pretty much a win, I guess.
Yeah, at this point it doesn't really become more of a percent game combo game. Yeah. At this point it's trying to play the stage.
And then another thing is the bomb is hits up smash, it's a really fast move and really reliable cover, and it hits through them, so that'll just help out Sorbet a lot.
He's really trying to go in with multi hits. Really hoping that Pokemon is going to mess him up. Ooh, tried to bring the spy back to work. That's close though. I think that would have killed. It would have been a nice amount of damage though. I don't know if Pit's up smash kills like 63.
No, especially because Pit's using a good amount of hits still.
Yeah.
I'd like to see a bigger usage of the light arrows.
Yeah, I would too.
Yeah, it seems like Sorbet really enjoys using them and he's really accurate. It's a pretty impressive thing to say for just Smash Brothers.
Just to give him a nice little poke on his face. Ooh, good spot though.
You see, the mistake of playing against Ryu is staying up in his face. You have to give Ryu a big square. Like, just a big square of space. Like, imagine that's just a box. Imagine you cannot get close to that perimeter. Because if you play in there, then that's when Ryu's toast. That's when everything catches you. That's when you start dying.
It's true. It's funny. When you're playing the game more like Street Fighter, Ryu has the advantage. You're up close personal boxing. This Rain Dead will just beat you at that. However, if you play him more of a smash character, that's what he said.
That's exactly.
Yep. Ooh, good play.
I had to follow up off that. I worked out there and I broke my pretty bread and butter pit combos.
Looks like maybe I guess he's holding that. Oh my god, thank you. Oh yeah, so that seems like.
Thank you. Bay seems to have the inherent advantage right now. He's carrying off his men pretty well. If there's a couple more reads, and he'll be able to steal the stock.
Really? I really, really wish Sobei would stay away from him. He can play his game.
Yeah, like just rushing him in.
And I mean, he's getting grabbed. He's got him offstage already, which is good enough.
He's gotta watch out for these tilts.
You think that was Lylat's, like, stage? That didn't let him grab it? He kind of like just far enough. Pressure moves a bunch of barrels, go off stage, he's got all the jumps in the world, he does not. Good down smash, covered in the barrel.
More pressure. Ooh, that nice. Arrow's
good
gonna do
snipe.
It.
There we go.
Look at him, dude. This guy looks happy about it. Oh, no. I didn't transition into time for his expression. That was priceless.
It was.
Ooh, okay. That. Little flying arrow, the flying arrow that could, man.
Alright, he banned Town and City. It looks like he's gonna take advantage of that ban. Ryu used to get a nice advantage because of the 30th in there, but since the ban looks like he's
gonna go FD?
Diddy Kong. I don't know how I feel about Diddy Kong. I feel like Diddy Kong's projectiles might be a little harder to manage with your arrows than your reflector, but I'm pretty sure he outplays him in neutral. I think it should be good.
I was about to say, we should be seeing Diddy Kong on FD. That's a pretty hard thing to get around, because Diddy Kong on FD is just a monster of a laser.
He's got all the tools needed.
Oh, alright, Minute Jason's just gonna play the keep away game, and Sorbet being more of a rushdown guy, this might show more results for me.
Yeah, I definitely see how this is going on. But, not to say that Sorbet doesn't have the advantage to adapt what he's doing to try to react a little harder to the pressure that he's doing. I'm sure he's dealt with his pressure of Diddy Kong's as well.
He was talking in a group chat earlier, a while back, he was saying that he was really struggling again with this Diddy Kong and like playing this Diddy Kong that he plays with Komodos, that he got double eliminated by him, he was the only person stopping him. So that's one thing. One major thing that should be kept in mind in this matchup is how much you have to respect the banana.
Yeah.
Yes. You have to give that banana as much respect as if it were another player. Because if you don't, the moment you stop respecting the banana is the moment you start taking a lot of damage and get stuck in the Diddy Kong vortex.
And I mean, you can tell that right now. He hasn't really been respecting it that much. Just look at the percent differences. I mean, he's gotten into 134 and he just keeps getting all these things and ground
attack. So that's going to do it. And now he's off a stock with barely 31% on it.
Yeah, it's looking very nice for him. Right, Jason, if you have 200
pieces. Yes.
So it might be on his stock here. Okay. Not so good down smash, just damage one for the down smash, just seal it off.
Yep, getting a good round of distance there. Although Sorbet has been doing a pretty good job of not letting him pull the banana out to begin with.
That was an interesting little system. Maybe he made it shielded. Just trying to stop him getting the banana position for the grab. No damage off of that. Try to keep him off the rails. He's using his shelf very wisely when he's upstage to recover onto this stage.
Yeah, try not to get himself into the position where he's gonna have to use a special move to recover because that would become a good one.
That was an interesting shape. It looks like he attacked and then slipped, so he got the big combo.
At least he got a point from him.
Yeah, definitely. There's a fair trade, I suppose. Good arrow pressure. Not good for anything. Try catching the monkey flip.
Okay, forward air, man. That forward air is such a huge hitbox.
Yeah, it is.
Diddy Kong, man.
Yeah. Not going for it. Grab the banana.
So Sorbet just sat there and jabbed about 10 times.
Nice. Good use of it. Yeah, definitely. I'm telling you, man, in neutral, it's just... I don't know how I don't necessarily understand what he's trying to
okay.
Can't believe it. I mean, I can't. Yeah, maybe. Oh, smash it.
That's gonna do it. Yeah. Nick Jace takes it.